Welcome to a special edition of First Gear. Today we'll be finding out what is the most economical and efficient way of travel by taking part in the race to end all races.
The challenge is simple. Start from one of Perth's most iconic locations, Optus Stadium, and be the first one to arrive at the school. Each person will be using a different mode of transport to highlight its unique advantages and disadvantages.
And I'll start off by saying the fastest and most obvious way to get back to the school would be by driving. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce the Subaru Impreza WRX. Packed with a 2-litre turbocharged boxer engine capable of producing 227 horsepower, this beast can go from 0 to 100 in under 5.9 seconds. Comes with everything: ABS, DSG, ESP, EBD, BRB, ASAP. Okay, maybe not the last two, but it's got a lot packed into it. Japanese engineering at its finest.
So you're having all those features while you're stuck driving at snail pace in the middle of peak hour traffic?
Well, what do you suggest would be the best way to travel?
This is the TCR Advanced Road Bike made by Giant Manufacturing. Full carbon fiber straight blade with a fully integrated superlight alloy, weighing in at 9 kilos, fitted with a KMC 11 speed chain. This beauty is powered by 100% all natural self-sustaining Basso.
Well, Basso, this isn't just going to be a two-way race. I think now would be a great time to introduce a third racer, the possible dark horse of the challenge.
Some say he has a third nipple and a matching third testicle.
Some say he can kill two stones with one bird.
But all we know is
he's called the Stag. All right, this challenge will begin in 3, 2, 1. Another red line. Honestly, why would you put a traffic light every bloody 10 meters? Bloody red lines, come on. You know, this might actually be a closer race than I first thought. Peak hour traffic and congestion is pretty bad right now. Where possible, try to avoid driving on major roads and freeways between 7 and 9 in the morning and 4 to 6 in the afternoon. Funny, the more you're in a rush, the more people will drive. drive really, really slow. Not that I'm advocating speeding, but if the limit says 60, drive 60, please. Now, although this car drives faster than lightning, in stop-start traffic, the only thing this bad boy is burning through is fuel. Maybe a little bit of moss. But that means I'm going to have to do a bit of a detour at your local servo. If you're not a car enthusiast, then I wouldn't blame you for not knowing what the different fuel types are. When filling up, it's the numbers that really matter. Standard unleaded petrol is given a 91 rating, while premium unleaded is both 95 and 98. There are also two ethanol-based fuels, E10 and E85. These are the more environmentally friendly options, but it is super important that you check whether your car is compatible with these. The last type of fuel is diesel. Standard unleaded petrol is the most common fuel type, whereas premium unleaded is designed to be more fuel efficient and provide higher engine power and functionality. It is meant for use by high performance cars, like yours truly, but can be used by a majority of cars. Double check with the manufacturer of your car what the recommended fuel type is. Now remember, if you ever put diesel into an unleaded fuel tank, it's adios engine and hello expensive trip to the mechanic.
This is how I refuel. There are certain advantages that a bike has to offer. However, on the whole, cyclists must follow the same rules as drivers when riding on the road. Stop at stop signs, only turn when you're allowed to, and follow the flow of traffic. As well as these standard laws, each state have their own unique laws regarding bike helmets or riding on the footpath. In WA, you must wear a helmet at all times or risk a $50 fine. All right, time to ride or die.
We just hit a milestone. This is the last traffic light for the next 10 kilometers. So after this, it is smooth sailing. We're just getting off Tonkin Highway onto Champion Drive. It's the home stretch. Fingers crossed, I'm the first one back at the school. 3 minutes away from school. Hang on, is that Basso? This is the race to the finish. I just saw Shannon, she's going down the opposite driveway.
Challenge is
the Stag. Oh, it's Berno! So the moral of the story here is that regardless of what way you travel,
whether it's by car, bike, or public transport,
always plan your journey ahead of time.
Remember to avoid driving during peak hour times, and if you can, try to carpool to lower congestion on the roads.
Cycling is now becoming a popular choice for transport as it's cheap and healthy way to drive short distances.
And combined with public transport, you'll be able to reach most locations within the Perth metropolitan area.
We hope you had fun. I know we certainly did. Be safe, be responsible, and as always,
we'll see you next time on First Gear.